Hey, good morning, everyone. Day 41 of Coffee and Devotions with PD. Got my coffee this morning. Feeling really good this morning. It is the day before Mother's Day. It's Mother's Day Eve. And I want to entitle this devotional today, Praying for You, Mom. I'll tell you exactly why. Well, first of all, it should be a no-brainer to be praying for Mom. But it's the mamas that have been praying for us, for so many of us, for so many years, that have made the difference. I'm decked out in some of my Nike gear. Nike is a very popular brand, and it is a Greek word for victory. And I want to tell you something straight up right now. If it wasn't for the praying mamas in my life, especially when I was a teenager, I wouldn't be where I am today. I wouldn't be the man that I am today. And it's those mamas that prayed me out of some defeat into some great victory. And so I think it's time that we spend a little time praying for you, Mom. And that's what we're going to do here this morning. I want to honor all moms, period. And I don't want to label moms. I remember when we were growing up, or even some of my younger formative years of ministry, we would classify it as stay-at-home moms. We want to honor stay-at-home moms, and we want to honor, you know, those moms that are working outside the house. Listen, it doesn't matter where you're working. Moms are working. Moms are playing. Moms are awesome. Moms are celebrated, because we celebrate every incredible woman of God and what she means to us, and what she brings to her world, and what she brings to her family, and what she brings to the body of Christ. So we just want to thank you, for every one of you, as amazing ladies who have brought so many of us guys into greater places of victory. And we want you to know we're thinking about you today. So we're going to be praying for you, Mom. And as we do this morning, we're just going to take a couple of minutes. I'm going to actually, you know, pray God's word over all of you moms this morning. And I want to just put out a really special honor to my wife, Tamara, who has given to me three amazing sons, Braden, Caleb, and Joel. And I want to just so celebrate and honor the wisdom that my wife has as a mother, the integrity that she has as a mother, the work ethic, the play ethic, the grace, the compassion, the joy that she carries, the peace, just the serenity that she brings as an incredible mom to every situation. And I just want you to know, babe, that I love you. And I just really honor you as the mother of our children. So all of you ladies out there, I know that there's some of you that maybe you're not a biological mother, but you are a mother spiritually and emotionally to so many people. And we just want to say that you are so valued. Every single one of you as ladies, again, are so valued. So we're going to take a couple minutes and make some declarations of victory of Nike over your life today, being Mother's Day Eve. This is how we're going to start. Isaiah chapter 40. God's word says it like this as we pray it through. Dear Lord, we thank you for every hardworking mother, and we pray that you will give them the same strength declared in your word. When they're weak, it is you who gives them power, and when they have no might, you increase their strength. Father, I pray that every mama would lean not on their own human ability, but instead would find comfort in your supernatural, never-ending strength and your never-ending love. Philippians chapter 4. Heavenly Father, I thank you for who you are. Your word says that every mama can do all things through Christ who strengthens them. So Lord, I pray for every mom and ask that you will help them to understand their value, and that they are aimed in the direction of greatness because of you. Thank you for being their ultimate strength. And I pray that you also will help them to balance whatever their work looks like in regard to mothering, so that it can be well with their soul. Psalm 118, we pray this. Righteous Father, we cry out to you in this time, even of distress and pressure that the world is under today. And we thank you that you set every mother free from the burdens that they feel right now. Lord, you are for them and you'll never be against them, so every mom will not fear. We know that nothing that any mother faces, Lord God, on this earth can outweigh your power. So we bless them and we give you all the glory and all the praise and all the honor for them. And lastly, Galatians chapter 6. Eternal Heavenly Father, we pray for every mom who may feel lonely and stressed right now. Lord, let them not be tired or weary in well-doing. We know that every mom, Lord God, faces struggles, but they don't face those struggles alone. So Lord God, you will buoy them up, strength upon strength, Lord God. Help them push past every difficulty by your sovereign grace so that they can experience the blessings that you have in store for them and their families. Listen, every one of you as mom, we're praying for you today. We celebrate you. We honor you. Every one of the ladies in our lives, we honor and celebrate you. We believe that this day is holding victory for you because you are destined for victory from God. And we want to hold you up. Moms, us guys, we're praying for you today. We're praying for every one of you and believing God for the greater things that are to come. Have a great day. Enjoy Mother's Day. Enjoy your families tomorrow in a very unique way. We'll see you soon.